This is a continuation of solutions to the trig test 2 review. Alright, for 6b we're asked to graph y equals the cosine of x over 3. So we have to know the basic cosine function, theta cosine theta. So remember these are our critical 4 points, and I think of those on the unit circle again. If we're just looking on the unit circle, we've got 1, 0, 0, 1, negative 1, 0, 0, negative 1. And the cosine is always the x coordinate of those ordered pairs. So at 0, the cosine's 1. Up at pi over 2, it's 0. Over at pi, we've got negative 1. 3 pi over 2, we're at 0. And at 2 pi, we're at 1 again. So we do have to know that basic graph of y equals cosine x. So this is 2 pi. We know that we've got 0, 1. It starts up, right? And then it goes down to 0. And then down to negative 1. And then back up in here. And the same thing over on the left side. So if we were going to graph two periods, it would look like this. Okay, so you have to know the basic cosine function already. And let's see, there's nothing in front of the cosine, so it's a 1, so the amplitude is just 1. Right, it's the absolute value of the coefficient. And now the period of this is not going to be 2 pi. For just y equals cosine theta, it would just be 2 pi, just like the sine. But the period is going to be the regular period of cosine, which will be 2 pi, divided by the coefficient of x here. All right, so in this case, you don't see it, but there's a 1 there, right? So this is like 1/3 x. So it's really 2 pi over b, or it's the reciprocal of that coefficient. So you could think of it as 2 pi divided by 1/3, which is 2 pi times the reciprocal, or 6 pi. Okay? A faster way, if you prefer, is to just do 2 pi times the reciprocal of what's multiplied. So what's going to happen is the picture for cosine of pi over 3 is going to look exactly like this, except instead of it going from 0 to 2 pi, if we just change that to 6 pi, we've got what we want. So if that's 6 pi, this of course would be 3 pi, right? If this is 6 pi instead of 2 pi. And now we have the new function. All right? So if you label it so that you've got the correct period going from 0 to 6 pi, you're done. Otherwise, you could have left this at 2 pi and then redrawn the graph. It's going to look exactly the same. So that's the shortcut way of doing it, is graph y equals cosine x and then just change the values, so half of that. And of course, if you're going to put label all of these, this is going to be halfway between 0 and 3 is 3 pi is 3 over 2, right? So it's 3 pi over 2. Right here, right? And halfway between here, let's see, what would that be? That would be like, I'm going to think of that as, it's just the average of 3 pi and 6 pi, so it's 9 pi over 2. Okay, and then of course 6 pi would have been your 12 pi over 2, so it does make sense. If it's easier for you, you could label everything as something over 2. You could label the 3 pi here as 6 pi over 2, and the 6 pi is 12 pi over 2. Sometimes people like to see it that way, then the intervals, just writing them in reduced form. Okay, so we never wrote down what the period was going to be, but the period is this 6 pi. So make sure that you remember to write that down. There is no phase shift because there is no plus or minus inside this parentheses, and there is no vertical shift because there's no plus or minus after the parentheses as well. So that would be the answer to this problem. You've given the amplitude, the period, and you've done two periods of the graph y equals cosine x over 3. All right, we're on 6c. We're going to graph y equals 2 sine pi x over 3. All right, so let's do the amplitude first. The amplitude is the absolute value of the coefficient of sine, so it's 2. That's the absolute value of 2. And how about the period? Okay, now you have to think of what is the coefficient of x. It's pi over 3. So you take the period of pi, which is 2 pi, I'm sorry, the period of sine, which is 2 pi, and divide by pi over 3, which means the same thing as multiplying by 3 over pi. Is everybody okay with that? If you're dividing by pi over 3, it's the same thing as multiplying by 3 over pi. So the pi's cancel, and check this out. You have a period of just 6. So what's that look like? Well, just going to do our, we know it like always breaks up into these special points, and it usually goes from 0 to 2 pi, right? But instead it's going to go from 0 to 6, right? Here's the regular old theta sine theta, just as a reminder. You go from 0 to 2 pi, and then the points on the y-axis is 0, 1, 0, negative 1, 0. But instead of going from 0 to 2 pi, we're going to go from 0 to 6. So that's 3, right? And if you want to write, that's 1.5, and that's 4.5. You're just breaking it up. That's negative 1.5, etc. There's negative 6. And then on the y-axis, we're going to go by digits 1, 2, etc. Okay, remember it doesn't have to have the same marking on the x-axis as the y-axis. Okay, so now we just graph our little sine function that we're used to as if it was just y equals sine theta. So we've got this 0, it breaks up, right? Every other one is 0 right here. And the amplitude is 2, so when I go in this between one, usually you go pi over 2 and then up 1, but it's going to go twice as high up to 2. And then down here, I'm going to go down. So there is one period. Okay, but we want to keep going, so let's graph some points over here. And we've got our two periods of pi. And that's it. So we've got our amplitude of 2, period of 6. There's no phase shift, and there's no vertical shift, and so we're done.